Hello there, Matt with LINBIT here, and in this demo I'm going to show you how we can use Kubernetes to provision and deploy persistent replicated DRBD volumes for containers via LINBIT's Linstor Flex Volume Provisioner. We'll also be deploying a MySQL database onto our DRBD replicated volume and then compare the database's performance on top of DRBD to the database's performance on top of local host path storage from the same storage subsystem. If you want to follow along at home, before getting into the Kubernetes stuff, you'll need to initialize a Linstor cluster and at least one storage pool on your Kubernetes nodes. You could also do this on a single node using Minikube or something like that if you're just interested in testing things out. Either way, check out the DRBD9 user's guide at linbit.com for detailed instructions on how to set up Linstor. You'll also need to deploy the Linstor external provisioner and the Linstor Flex Volume plugin from LINBIT's GitHub onto your Kubernetes nodes. Links to all these sources will be in the description below. So once that's in place, we're ready to start creating our Kubernetes storage definitions and workloads. In our terminal right now, you can see that we've got a Linstor and Kubernetes cluster up with Pippin as our controller and master respectively, and Gimli and Mary as satellites and kubelets respectively. So we'll start by creating our storage classes. With Linstor, we can have many storage pools, allowing administrators to choose which storage they carve their persistent volumes from. Most admins will probably want to pull up their faster storage for I/O demanding workloads, then their more dense storage for general purpose workloads, and maybe some cloud storage for off-premise workloads. And all that flexibility is possible with Linstor. I've created three different storage pools in Linstor in my demo systems just to show you what that would look like. And I'll list those out there. So these storage pools are ready to be defined in Kubernetes. And I've created a few different storage class definitions to demonstrate how to control the provisioning of the storage. For example, you can specify specific nodes participating in a storage pool to deploy volume replicas to, or you can simply tell Linstor how many replicas of your volume you want and from which storage pool a volume should be carved from, and Linstor will auto-place them for you. So in these storage class definitions, you'll see on the left that we're defining that we want two replicas auto-placed on any node participating in the fast Linstor storage pool. And on the right, we're defining specific nodes, Mary and Gimli, for the replicas of our volumes, and that we want those carved from the slow storage pool. In this demo, we'll create a two replica auto-place storage class for our fast storage pool. And I'll show you what that definition looks like here. Pretty simple. And we'll tell Kubernetes to create it. And there it is defined in Kubernetes. We can now create DRBD-backed persistent volumes from the storage class we just defined using Kubernetes. I'll create a 10 gigabyte volume to back our MySQL database using this YAML file here. Let me clear that. Again, fairly simple. And there we go, we see the provisioning succeeded. Then we can switch to Linstor and look at what it looks like from Linstor's perspective. And we see we have one resource deployed to two nodes, Gimli and Mary. Now if we flip over to Gimli, we see a DRBD device there. And we're currently resyncing to Mary. Finally, we can deploy our MySQL server with our DRBD replicated persistent volume mounted to varlib MySQL, along with a MySQL service so our client containers will be able to access the database. I've already defined that here. So we got our service up top and then our deployment below. And we're just setting some parameters for our client to be able to access it. The most interesting part being the name of our persistent volume claim that we just created and the mount path at var libmysql. We'll tell Kubernetes to create that deployment. We see the service and the deployment created. And we'll have it describe that deployment. And we see that it is being created. So now that we have our MySQL server running on top of a Linstor provision DRBD replicated volume, we can test some IOs. So DRBD replicates writes synchronously to its peers by default at the block level. So it should have some impact on performance, but I want to show you just how minimal that overhead is. So I've got a fairly large command here. It's pretty monstrous, actually. You can pause the video and take a look at exactly what that's doing. But the short version is it's deploying a MySQL client, installing Sysbench on the client, creating a test database on the server, and then running our benchmark workload on that database. And I'll run this now, and then we can flip over to Gimli and see that DRBD is receiving and replicating writes. And then finally I'll flip back to our benchmark and truncate the video, as this is a 10-minute benchmark, so you don't want to sit here for 10 minutes, I'm sure. We are already currently writing data because of the resync, so we'll have to forgive the noise here and just watch for the resync rate to slow a bit when our actual writes start coming in. And there we see the writes starting to come in. We can tell because our resync progress has stalled out. That's DRBD preferring the application IOs over the resync IOs. And I'll actually snip this here because just creating the test database actually takes some time as well. So I'll be right back. Okay, and there are the results. I'll record our transactions per second, that being 601.47 per second. And then I'll destroy the MySQL server deployment and create a new deployment that uses the host path persistent volume to compare against these results. So we'll delete them there. And here is the YAML file we'll use for the host path persistent volume. And we'll go ahead and create that. And I'll describe it again for good measure. And once more, we'll run that monstrous command. And this will run the same exact benchmark against the now host path persistent volume. And once it's all done, we'll calculate the difference between the two. Okay, and finally, we see the results of our host path storage test, and we see we have pulled down 636.58 transactions per second. And that's a decrease of about 5.52, or exactly 5.52%. Which is a little high. We usually shoot to get to 3% or lower, but it's still a very small overhead when you consider we have a complete and total replica of all our writes on some other node, just in case this node happens to fail catastrophically. We haven't lost our data. So a small price to pay. And I bet after some tuning, we can get that number down further. Read balancing comes to mind as a quick way of doing that. But we'll have to cover all the tuning in another video, as this one's quite long already. But as I said before, the GitHub links in the description below contain not only the provisioner's source code and instructions for building, but also some example YAML files like the ones I used in the demonstration. So if you're interested in trying this at home, you can find those there. For more information on any part of what you've seen or heard, head over to linbit.com and reach out to us. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.